Hello and welcome back students to the new class of utilization of electric power. As you all know that utilization of electric power, particularly these subjects, covers four different aspects of electrical engineering. One is electric traction, another is illumination engineering, electric welding, and the last one, but not the least, it's electric heating. So today in this video, we are going to cover electric heating. Electric heating means what are the requirement of heating, especially different types of heating materials, different types of heating instruments that we use in our domestic and definitely in industrial purpose. So what are the different types of heating materials that should be used in industrial appliances? What are the different appliances we use in domestic purpose? But what are the advantages of one type of heating than another types of heating? This detailed study will be done here. So let us start electric heating. So first of all, we need to know what is electric heating. Definitely whenever there is an energy, when electrical energy is being converted to energy, that is electric heating. So electric heating, it's a process in which electrical energy is converted to heat energy. Now common application includes space heating, cooking, water heating, and industrial process. Industrial process, it includes a huge application of electric heating. In each and every aspect, you can have the application of different types of electric heater. Now, an electric heater is an electrical device that converts an electric current into heat. The heating element inside every electric heater is an electrical resistor and works on the principle of Joule heating. An electric current. Now, what is Joule heating? What is Joule's principle? Whenever an electric current passing through a resistor, that will convert the electrical energy into heat energy. Mainly nichromware, in today's application, modern electric heating device are used nichromware. The heating element depicted on the right uses nichromware supported by ceramic insulator. Since nichromware produces a highest amount of heat today, it must be surrounded with equivalent insulating material. And nowadays, these nichromwares are being surrounded with ceramic insulators. Now, what are the advantages of electric heating? Why don't we opt any other types of heating? What are the main advantages? Why do we prefer electric heating than any other types of heating? So these are some points. So electric heating is free from dirt, hence minimum effort for cleaning is required. It is free from flue gases, hence no need of exhaust system for heat generation. Temperature control can be done very easily. An electric heating system is economical compared to other conventional heating system available in the industry. Both the installation cost and running cost are low. Automatic protection against any abnormality in the heating system can easily be provided in electrical heating. The efficiency of the heating is quite high compared to other equivalent heating systems. The electric heating system is noise free and starting of the system is quite faster than other heating systems. So if we summarize the advantages of electric system, electrical system is cost effective. First of all, electrical system doesn't have huge amount of installation cost. Electrical system is free from noise. Electrical system is always much more cleaner than any other type of system. In electrical system, starting, breaking, all these kinds of procedure can be done easily. So these are the advantages of electrical heating. Now, types of heating. These are the different types of heating. Any types of heating you can think that comes under these categories. Each and every types of heating comes under this category. This is the whole classification of electric heating. So electric heating can be broadly classified into three types: resistance heating, arc heating, and high frequency heating. Now again, resistance heating is being classified under direct resistance heating and indirect resistance heating. Arc heating is again classified as direct arc heating, indirect arc heating, and high frequency heating, it is classified induction heating, dielectric heating, and infrared heating. Again, induction heating can be classified as direct induction heating and indirect induction heating. So from your semester point of view, this is one question that comes in the semester. Write down the classification of electric heating. And in that case, you have to mention each and every types of electric heating. Next, we are going to discuss about different types of heating. So first of all, it's direct resistance heating. In the direct resistance heating, the current flows directly through the substance to be heated. The substance which is to be heated in an electric heating system is called charge. As here, the charge itself provides the path for passing current and heat gets produced in the charge itself. The efficiency of the system is quite high. Now, what are the application of direct resistance heating? Where we can see direct resistance heating? These are resistance welding and electrode boiler. Electrode boiler can be seen in some of our house in old age, old persons, or in previous years, electrode boiler were used to heat water, to boil water. So these are the example of direct resistance heating, where the electrode itself is being dipped into the water and the water itself is working as a charge, that is the substance to be heated. So direct resistance heating, electrode boiler, and resistance welding are the example of direct resistance heating. Here in this figure also you can see an example of direct resistance heating. Here the substance that is dipped, that is electrode, and it's dipped into a furnace. High resistance powder, that is actually the charge that is being heated, and it's connected, those electrodes are connected to the supply. Now what is indirect resistance heating? Electrical current passes through a resistive element where heat is produced due to ohmic laws. This heat is then transferred to the substance which is to be heated. So first, electric current is passing through an element which is actually producing a ohmic loss, and then that loss, the heat produced from that ohmic loss is being transferred to the substance to be heated. Now the example is electrical cooking heater oven, heat treatment system, immersion water heater. These are the example of indirect resistance heating. So here in this type of resistance, immersion boiling water, immersion heater, in electric cooking heater, in this type of elements, these are mainly used for domestic purposes. So in this type of elements, what is happening, electric current is first producing ohmic loss. How it can produce ohmic loss? It is passing through a resistive element, and that resistive element particularly is producing ohmic loss, and that loss is producing the amount of heat to be transferred. So here you can see the picture of indirect resistance heating, where supply is being connected to a resistance and the charge to be heated is separated from the heating element. It's not directly connected. Now arc heating. In very high temperature, arc heating can be obtained. Arc can be formed either between two electrodes of sufficient potential difference or between one electrode and the charge itself. In the second case, the charge itself behaves like the other electrode. Now, arc heating, again, these are of two types, indirect and direct type. Indirect arc heating, in the electric furnace where the arc is produced between two electrodes and the heat generated in the arc is transferred to the charge is known as the indirect arc furnace. But what is direct arc heating? In the electric furnace, where the arc is produced between the electrode and the charge itself, is called a direct arc furnace. These are two figures of indirect and direct arc furnace. But nowadays, this arc heating doesn't have much application, because to produce arc, an enormous amount of heat is needed to be generated, but that whole amount of heat cannot be used in the application. So arc heating itself is a costly one. So in today's application purpose, arc heating is not very suitable in terms of cost effectiveness. Next, direct induction heating. In the direct induction heating, this type of heating comes under high frequency heating. High frequency heating nowadays, it's a very useful from cost effectiveness, from cleanliness, from noise reduction. So first one is direct induction heating. The current gets induced in the charge itself due to the changing current nearby. Due to the inherent resistance of the charge, there is heat produced in the charge itself. Induction furnace and eddy current heater are two well-known examples of direct induction heating, where we keep the heating element near to the charge and always flow current through the heating element that produces in an induction process that produces a heat in the charge itself. So there is no direct connection between these two, the heating element and the charge itself. Indirect induction heating. In this method, heating elements of the furnace are heated up by the current induced in them by mutual induction of source coil. Whenever there is an induction heating, there is always a presence of mutual induction, whereas it's a direct induction or it's an indirect induction. This heat then gets transferred to the charge by radiation and convection. The indirect induction ovens are mainly used for melting of metals. So these are mainly used for industrial purpose. Now, dielectric heating. This is very difficult to uniformly heat up an installation material like wood, ceramic, plastic. Now, high frequency dielectric capacitive heating is employed whenever we need to heat wood, ceramic, these insulating material. Dielectric material connected between two electrodes behaves as a capacitor, and high frequency current can pass through the capacitor. The current through the capacitor causes uniform heating in the dielectric material. The frequency applied here is very high. It's 10 to 50 kilohertz. But since this type of heating is being used to melt insulating material like wood, ceramic, plastic, a huge amount of heat gets lost because of this high frequency generation. So in case of dielectric heating, we can consider the efficiency of this type of heating is very low. It's almost 50% of the total system. Now, the important one, it's infrared. But in India, infrared heating is not at all used, but it's being thought that infrared heating in industrial purpose, they are in thought that they try to incorporate this in their heating procedure because it's the simplest form of electric heating. Here, the electromagnetic radiation coming out from an incandescent light bulb, it's focused to the surface to be heated. But here, the problem is the amount of heat energy that is to be emitted from an incandescent light bulb, that amount of heat cannot be generated according to the industrial needs. So first we need to have that amount of incandescent light bulb so that we can generate that particular amount of heat that is to be needed in industrial purpose. So if in that amount of light can be generated, infrared heating will be most cost effective heating among industrial purpose. So what are the industrial application of electric heating? It's melting of metals, it's electric welding, it's molding of glass for making glass appliances, baking of insulator, molding of plastic components, heat treatment of pointed surfaces, and making of plywood. And domestic application, you all can know, you all can have this room heater, immersion heater, hot plates, geyser, electric kettles, electric iron, oven, toaster, etc. These are the domestic application of electric heating. So in this video, you have studied about a known term, but in a new process. Heating, we all know. Electric heating, we all knew. Electric heater, we all have heard about this term, about this equipment, but what are the different types? What are the different specifications that we have come across through this video? So in from semester point of view, the question that may come, one is classification of electric heating. In that particular question, you have to answer the whole classification that I have showed you. You have to write down the whole table, and each one of types of electric heating that may come as a separate question. Like write short note on dielectric heating, write short note on infrared heating. In that case, you have to first mention under which type of heating this particular heating comes. Then you have to mention their properties. Then you have to mention their application and the figure that is mentioned over here. Right? For book reference, you can go for J.B. Gupta. You can go for G.C. Girl, Electric Power or Utilization of Electric Power. And you can refer also Rajput. So thank you for watching this video. If you find any difficulties, if you find any queries, you can share that in the comment section and I will try, definitely try to solve that. Thank you once again.